Previously, you learned how to create one single PDF document via Python. In this video, you learn how to create multiple PDF documents with data fetched from an Excel file. The file we'll be using is this one in here. You can find this attached in this lecture as a resource. So let me quickly explain you what these data are. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 columns. And each row represents one type of animal. For example, the first one is about Malayan tigers. So you have the kingdom that a Malayan tiger belongs to, the phylum, so biological classification of animals. Then you have the class, the order, and the suborder. So each animal has their own classifications. Three animals we have here. Now, what we'll do is we will generate a PDF document for each of these rows. The documents will look like this. So we had the American black bear, the bumblebee, and the Malayan tiger. The American black bear PDF will look like this. So that's the name of the animal. And then we have the data here. So the kingdom is Animalia, the phylum is Chordata, etc. For the bumblebee, we also have these data. So these data obviously come from the rows in this Excel file. And of course, the PDFs will be generated in one single run of the script. So let's build this program. I'll delete these PDFs now. I'll go to the shell section and just say rm *.pdf execute. So now I'll start from scratch. First of all, we want to load the data into Python. We do that using pandas. So df is equal to pandas.read excel is the method. And this gets as input data.xlsx, the path to that Excel file. Now, for this to work, you need to have the fpdf package installed, the pandas package, and also you need to install in REPL. I have to install this with pip. So this is pip install open pyxl. So that's a dependency for reading Excel files for the pandas package. So you have to run that, and then the other ones you can install them from the graphical installer here. So fpdf and pandas, and you're good to go. So we load the data and let's print them out just to see if we read them correctly. Yeah, so that's our data frame. There is an error here, but I think that is some bugs related to REPL currently, because I don't see any error in our code here. So let's ignore that error. This is the data frame. So that's the same data as in the Excel file. We see that we have 0, 1, 2, so it's three rows, and this first row here, which you saw in here, that is the header. So Python automatically recognizes it as a header. And then it starts with this row, second, third, and each column. So now what we need to do is iterate over those data. We do that using for index row in df iter rows. That's a standard way to iterate over the data. Basically, what we get is, let me show you what index is first. So index is that 0, 1, 2. So we're printing out the index number for each row. And the rows themselves are, well, so let me comment that out and let's print the row. So this is what we get for rows. That's the first row from there to here. That's the second row. That's the third row. So each row has these pairs. The name of the column and the value of the column. So that's for the bumblebee. That's the name of the animal. That's the kingdom of the animal. The phylum of the animal and so on. So that's for the third row only. That's for the second row and that's for the first row. So we need to use these rows now somehow. We're gonna need to extract, for example, the name, which is that and that and that. And you can do that by entering here square brackets and in quotes name. So that's the name there. If you run that, you're gonna get Malayan tiger, American black bear, and bumblebee. If you enter kingdom, so the name of the second column, we just used name, now we use kingdom. Let's see. Run, and we get Animalia. So that's the same kingdom for all the animals here. So let's make use of that now. Instead of printing out, let's insert these data into our PDF, into a new PDF document. For that, we need to import from fpdf, import fpdf. Then we need to create an instance for that, but one instance corresponds to one PDF file, and we want three PDF files. In this case, we have three rows, three animals, three PDF files. Therefore, for each iteration, we want to insert here, we want to create that instance. So fpdf orientation is equal to p, so portrait mode, we covered that in the previous lecture, so you need to take that lecture if you didn't do so already. The unit of the fonts and the other elements will be in PT, so points, and the format will be an A4. Then we'll add a page to the PDF. It's an empty page for now. So then next, let's add the first item contents in the PDF. So we said that we want to add in the PDF page, we want to add content from top to bottom. So the first thing I want to add is some sort of a title. And I do have the code from the previous lecture to add the title, which was like this. I'm going to paste it here. So that is the code. We set the font times, it's a big font, 24 points in size. And then we add the cell. So the text was static, a static string, Malayan tiger, but we want to make this dynamic now. So instead of Malayan tiger, we will add here row name. Now, if I just call output right now, and as the name, I'll use an F string, so to make it dynamic, I'll do again row name, and outside the curly brackets, so that will be replaced by name, by the name of the animal, which is, for example, American black bear. And then at the end I'll add .pdf and run this. And there we go, we get three PDF files. That's the first title, the second title, bumblebee, and the third title. Now let's add those data down here. Again, I have the code from the previous lecture copied on my clipboard, so I'm gonna add it between this cell and the output method. So somewhere here, indent it properly to be under the for loop. So what we've got here is we add the text kingdom, and next to that we add the type of the kingdom, which is Animalia. Now this is a label, so that's the name of the column. So what we will do is we will just leave it kingdom. So that's the next column. And then change this to row kingdom. That's the name of the column. So that's just a label. We will insert that as simple text. But this will get the value from the current row. So the iteration goes like, in the first iteration, we are working on the first row, which is for Malayan tiger. And so we get the name for the Malayan tiger here, and then we get the kingdom for the Malayan tiger in here, and everything is written in this PDF file. So let me run this and check again. So American black bear, kingdom Animalia. All the animals are obviously the same kingdom, so everything is working fine. We can keep adding rows like that here. So I'm replicating that. And then the next column would be film. And then here we'd say film. So this will work if we keep doing that for all the columns, but since we're working on automation, it doesn't make much sense to keep repeating ourselves here with the code. So I think we can do better and automate this as well. So what I'll do is, just after we add the title in here, so that's for the title, this part here. After that, I will insert a new for loop. Let me see how we can do that. So just after the title, you see row name here. I'll say for column in df.columns. So I'm iterating over the column names, because df.columns is this series which gives us all the column names. But if we do for column in df.columns and we print the column here, we get access to all those columns. These are all strings now. And if we do for column in columns from the second column up to the last column, print column, that will print out all the columns but the first one. You see name is here, but it's not here because we excluded name. So when you say that, you're slicing that list by taking only those items, not the item with index 1. So let's make use of that for loop in here, say 1 to the end. And then instead of putting these texts in here, we make it dynamic. We say column, so kingdom. And if you want, you can make it a title case. So it will be something like kingdom.title, and K will be capitalized. So it's title. And if you want to keep the column here, then you want to use an F string. So F there, like that. Put that in curly brackets. So that's a dynamic part of a string, and then we have the static part. It's just a colon after kingdom, and then we go here. So this now kingdom is again replaced by column, because column in the first iteration is equal to kingdom, and that allows us to delete all these other ones. Right, we have this underline here, which means we have to indent this to make it syntactically correct. So that's indented under the first for loop, and that's indented under the second for loop. Of course, we didn't include these parts in the second for loop because we have to create one PDF document for each row. But then under the iteration of each row, we want to do something repetitive in each document. And the generation of the title is not repetitive, but this code was repetitive. So we had to include it in a for loop. And yeah, let's run this. And let's check. Yeah, looks good. Kingdom, film, class, order, suborder. That's for the American Black Bear. Let's see for Bumblebee. Yeah, we have other data. The class is Insecta, obviously. And that's how we can create multiple PDF reports via Python. If you're working with CSV data, of course, you can just change this to read CSV and then provide here the link to your CSV file, the path to your CSV file, and that should do it. So thank you for following, and I'll talk to you later. See you.